Oh, nice.
Yeah, the back of your head is on.
Just a quick review first. Here's my electron, pretend. Ready? Here's my electron. When it just sits there, there's this stuff around it called an electric field and a how much magnetic field. And it's for whatever reason, we don't know why, when it starts spinning, it produces a magnetic field. And when it moves like this, it produces a magnetic field. We don't know why that's true. Just leave it at that. That's okay, that's fine. And then the thought process is, well, gosh, if this produces a magnetic field, wouldn't this produce a bigger magnetic field? And wouldn't this produce a bigger magnetic field because it's more of a moving? And eventually we realized, you know what? If you just hook up wires to a battery and have a really, really simple circuit, you'd probably have bunches and bunches of moving electrons. And so right now the compass kind of lines up with the magnetic field lines of the Earth, but I made it line up with the wire. Okay? And then as soon as we turn this on, can you see the compass turning? Mm-hmm. So the wire was set up like this, initially maybe, and initially the compass matched that. I made it do that. And as soon as I turned the current on, the compass went, okay, it took a while to settle down with that. But eventually it settled down perpendicular to the wire. How do compasses always line up? Okay, and how to the strongest magnetic field? Tangent or parallel to the magnetic field. So our evidence that the magnetic field lines go like this compared to the wire is the fact that that's what the compass did. And then I switched it and put the compass underneath, and we found out yesterday that the magnetic field line pointed like that underneath. It's like this on top, like this on the bottom, mostly in your head kind of finished the picture and said, oh, it's actually circles. But the question is, would circles go this way, or do circles go this way? And you can answer that question with the left-hand rule. Yeah, the left-hand rule. It's got to be your left hand, so are most of you right-handed?
Is there anyone
left-handed here? That's me? Okay. Because I got to do it, and then pick up my pencil and write down the answer. You guys can do it and write down the answer at the same time. Lucky you. Alright? Let's just say the current is going that way. Take your left hand, stick it in the direction of the current. Do this with me, will you? Put it in the direction of the current. The magnetic field lines wrap this way, not this way. That's how you can tell. Okay? In fact, so if we were going to do that in a quiz, so the current's going that way. I ask you to draw the magnetic field. I'm going, oh, what am I going to draw? I mean, you can try to do stuff like this, and I guess that kind of looks like it, but it's best to show on top. Aren't they coming out of your face? So on top, we will probably do this. That means out. And then underneath is you going this way. So the best way to show it, maybe something like this. I mean, I can take that if you're a better artist than I am, which is not saying much. This was no questions asked. That is the picture of what magnetic field lines look like for a current-carrying wire. And so a current-carrying wire produces a magnetic field. Actually, any moving charge produces a magnetic field. Any moving charge produces a magnetic field. Physicists couldn't say seven words for some reason. So they came up with a term that means the same thing. And that is magnetic induction. Moving charge creates a magnetic field. Maybe it's six words. Moving charge creates a magnetic field. That says the same thing in two words. Have we used this word before? Mm-hmm. We have. When we had balloons and we talked about moving the pop can and how the charges move over here. So rather than saying, when you move a charged object near a neutral object and the mobile charges move to the other side, we said induction. It says the same thing. Probably when I say induction, because I've done it for so many years, I know exactly what it means. You guys got to stop and think. That's fair at your stage of the game. So there's electric induction and there's magnetic induction. Both of them don't involve touching, because there's nothing really touching anything here at all. And that's what the general term induction means. So, what the heck is magnetic induction again? Moving charges create a magnetic field. That's what it is. We've seen it, right? There's your evidence. We still don't know why, but I've shown you that it's true. We've got a word for it. We know what they look like. You just got to at some point internalize that. And I'm not saying that it's easy, because it's not. And then we said, well, what if you start doing things like wrapping the wire in a coil like this? And we had an aid for that, which was simply this, when I hang on to it, because the wire is kind of floppy. So if a wire comes in and goes like this, it goes around, 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 and comes back out, magnetic field, do I have my left hand? Yes, my left hand. Okay, good.
Go like this. You guys would do it like this, wouldn't you?
Magnetic field lines in here would point up, right? Out and down. Right? Which way is the current going? Yeah, I guess I can do something this way. So magnetic field line would point up, out, and down. About over here.
About now.
Yeah, up in the middle, right? Up, they would go like this. Keep going. They're always up in the middle. Over here, it's still up in the middle. What you're supposed to picture then is that coil of wire, we said up in the middle. So the magnetic field lines would look something like this. And that looks incredibly like the magnetic field lines for, yes, a regular bar magnet. That's what they look like for a bar magnet. That's what they look like for a coil wire. So whenever you coil up wire like this, you've essentially made a bar magnet. And I showed you that yesterday with this. Because this is just a bunch of coils of wire. Let's try this. Not only is it coils of wire, what's in the middle?
A magnet.
Well, it's not a magnet right now. It's magnetizable stuff. Yeah, it is magnetizable. It's just not a magnet yet. What happens if we don't have that stuff in there?
It still works.
Still works as well? Probably not. We can try to show that. I mean, here's a bunch of the coils of wire with nothing in the middle. And it's pretty easy to connect on there. It's not hard to do. And we can put our paper clip down in the same spot, can't we? Alright, we'll put them, here's our test. We'll put them one square apart. How's that? Alright, here's our test. It didn't do anything so far. Okay, let's try this. This is not very strong. How about a magnet itself? A little closer, maybe? Not really doing anything. Bunch of the coils of wire should work just fine. But the difference is, I'm going to lose stuff. There we go. Okay. When we make, in fact, there's fewer coils here, aren't there? And yet the difference is this stuff that's in here, when we turn the current on, will become magnetized. So the idea is then you'll have not only the magnetic field from the wires themselves, in addition, you'll also have the magnetic field from that stuff that becomes magnetized. And it makes a huge difference. When you put stuff in there like that, that becomes magnetized. To be fair, same distance, okay? One square's worth, that's a big difference. So just by putting magnetizable stuff in the middle, your electromagnet becomes much stronger. Electromagnets work on the property, or the process of magnetic induction. Moving charges, right? Aren't they moving charges like crazy? And they created a magnetic field. So electromagnets, that's what this is, work on the process of magnetic induction. It's so much better when you can put something that's magnetizable in the middle like that. It's kind of cool. Not a bad use. You know? Showed you how speakers work yesterday. That's a use that you have every day of your life. I can't imagine maybe going through the day without listening to some kind of music at some point, or in the car or something like that. So that's a pretty good use of it. Alright, where are we going to go from here? Well, let's go to something else that's really, really useful for you every day of your life. The motor. It happens to be an electric motor. And I'm going to clip some leads on there. Clip a lead on there. And turn the power on. And let's see, spacing's not quite what I wanted it, but it's close. There we go. Alright. That's pretty useful, isn't it? Yeah, well, little bit of spark, yeah. Go, ah, cool. How about more than cool? How about, is there anything that actually uses that? Anything that you use relatively often? Like what? Okay, so electric motor, so I suppose electric cutter, but not quite. So anything that can turn in a circle like that, because here's the next thing you can do, is you can put stuff on the edges, like fan blades, and that's how electric fan works. And you can maybe make it look a little bit different, but put it in something that's almost shaped like a gun, called a drill. That's how that works. And you can make bread with it, or mashed potatoes when you put it on something called a blender. Right? Anything that goes in a circle like that you plug in has that stuff inside it. What kind of stuff do you see? Can you put it here so I can see a little better? What kind of stuff do you see?
Coils.
See the coils? These things right here, on this side and this side, are magnets. Okay. We're going to get gory details here in a minute, but basically, real basically, when the current goes through the coils of wire, don't they become magnetized? And these magnets on the ends are always magnetized, alternatingly attracted and repelled, which basically goes around and around. This works on the process of magnetic induction. As soon as the current goes through those coils of wire, they become a magnet. In fact, more details here. This stuff right here, what kind of stuff is it? Magnetizable stuff. If I pulled it out, I bet it wouldn't work very well. Because we already showed, if you don't put the magnetizable stuff in there, it doesn't work very well. Yeah, that's exactly what that stuff is. This stuff right here is something that is magnetizable. And when the current goes through there, it becomes magnetized. That's exactly right. But, probably need a little bit more details than that. And we're going to need a little bit of help here. You gotta pretend with me, okay? This is not string, this is a wire. It's not a meter stick, it's magnetizable stuff. You know what, I am missing some things. Okay, put that down on your desk. I'm gonna come in the middle of it, you can set it down for now. My cards, where did my cards go? Oh well, we'll make some new ones. You can always improvise. Alright, here's what I'm gonna need. I'm gonna need a positive and a negative end of the battery. So I'll make one big plus, big negative. Maybe you just can be into the battery. Okay. I'm gonna need these outside magnets, one of which has north, they both have north and south, so I need that. I had these earlier, I'm sure they went. Tape just in case, and then try to video in the middle if you can. I'm gonna grab my seat. Actually, come a little closer this way. Grab that thing too. Actually, yeah, you can be negative, that'll work. Not that you're a negative person, it's obviously being negative. Sorry. Thank you, guys. I'm sorry. I had all these cards ready to go before. Right. Actually, let's do it this way. You can leave that there, and I'll take this. Because it's going to have to turn like this. Actually, you know what? Can you just hold everything? Vanna, thank you. Okay. All right. Actually, you're going to be a part of a magnet, and so are you. Okay? And we are pretending like crazy, but here's how this goes, okay? Here's the magnetizable stuff, here's the coil of wire, here's the ends of the battery, okay? Here's how this worked. As that thing twirled around, can you see the, you can't really see the copper parts. It's hard to see again. It's so hard to see. Yeah, that's much, much better, isn't it? All right. These copper parts right here, they eventually attach up to the battery itself. So as this thing, can you also see the pivot that goes right through the center? Can you see that?
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Thanks for pretending. So I can just flutter this around. These things are going to touch ends of the battery, okay? Right now they're not touching. When they're not touching, there's no current. So nothing happens. To get it started, do you notice how to push it? Mm-hmm. I push it so when, hey, it touched. There's current now going through here. Doesn't this produce a magnetic field in here?
Yes.
Yes, no? This whole thing becomes magnetized. Just for the sake of argument, because it doesn't really matter which way it goes, let's just say this becomes magnetized north, which would mean this becomes magnetized south, wouldn't it? I don't care which is which necessarily. Okay? Can you see what would happen? Mm. Doesn't this end get repelled by that? And this end gets
attracted
because the air gets south. Okay? By the, so, then really, you're the other half of his magnet. I didn't feel the need to draw you. You're south, you're north. Okay? You're north. You guys are a magnet, and you guys are a magnet. Does that make sense? I didn't feel the need to draw the other half because it's irrelevant right now. So, this gets pushed away by Maddie and pulled by you. This gets
pushed by me
and pulled by Maddie. So, guess what it does?
Spins.
Well, of course it spins. And these things, maybe they're a little bit longer than this, because they drag for a little bit of time. We'll make them a little bit longer. And they do. God, that tape's old, isn't it? I've done this a few times before. They drag for a while, but at some point they get to about right here, and these things don't touch anymore. Well, if they don't touch anymore, there's no more current, is there? If there's no more current, then this stuff is not...
Magnetic.
So there are no poles anymore. And you think, oh... It probably just stops, right?
No.
No, it's got...
Momentum's
a good word. Better word?
Inertia.
Yeah. Momentum's actually a really, really good first try. It's better even inertia. So it just keeps spinning. Why? Because it's got inertia. And it comes right over about here, and it just happens to touch again. Gosh! And which was which?
North, south.
Actually, a minute ago, this was north over here, wasn't it? But see, the current determines which way the poles go. Now this end's going to be north again. And this end's going to be north again. And you're going to shove that away, and you're going to pull it, and you're going to shove this one away, and you're going to pull it. So guess what it does?
Spins again.
It turns, yeah. Hey, not touching. You're not doing a good job touching.
I'm sorry.
I'm kidding. And now it does. This is actually pretty good. Look how far it's gone. It's still touching. But it's, oh, it doesn't touch anymore. As soon as it doesn't touch anymore, there's no current, there's no magnetic field. You'd think it would just stop, but it doesn't, because it has inertia, so it keeps going, right? In fact, you know what? Actually, I don't want it to still be magnetized at this point. Remember the reason it went this way? Wasn't it south? Well, what if it was still south? Wouldn't it go and sit?
Yep.
I don't want it to still be magnetized. I wanted to forget that just long enough to go right on by and touch again. Whew. I know this doesn't quite look like that. The thing we're kind of missing is this, and those are those copper parts in there. But this thing becomes all, and what's weird, every time this thing comes around, it says it becomes north. Now it comes over there, it becomes south. When it comes back over here, it becomes north. I'm glad we have that magnetizable stuff in there. It makes things go a lot better. What's weird, is this magnetizable stuff has to become magnetized one way, and a split second later, it's got to forget its magnetism and now become magnetized the other way. We're asking a lot of that substance. I'm glad it does it. It's kind of cool. Mm-hmm. Thank you. There is a cute video that goes with this. I don't think you're going to watch it. I said, okay, look, a drill, a blender. My biggest one's the fan. I like that one the best. Isn't that inside the computer to cool them down? His biggest thing was electric toothbrush. Okay, I suppose. I had to pick something. Didn't they have an electric candle? That's kind of the same thing. Is there anything else you can think of like that? It goes in a circle, it's electric.
What about a vacuum cleaner?
Yeah, okay, yes, inside the vacuum cleaner. Something's got a turbo, yeah, exactly.
Well, turntable and microwave.
Oh, okay. Turntable, microwave oven. I like that. Well, true. Well, yeah. How would you like your food inside to be going and spatter all over the place? I'm glad it's slow.
That would actually be kind of fun.
Well, maybe once in a while. If you think that's fun, then just use a blender and stuff. Yeah. Everything that we just talked about works the same way. What's hard to see a little bit, those things that I had, those things hanging off, that's these right here. And those are made out of copper, so they conduct really well. Now be careful, it's copper. Does copper become magnetized?
No.
No, it doesn't. People are still, again, there's a lot of stuff going on. When I show them the picture of this, I think, oh, so that stuff becomes magnetized. No, it doesn't. when I, even in the very, very beginning, when all we did was take the wires from like this and put the compass under here, did the wire become magnetized? No. The magnetic field surrounded it, but the magnet, you know, the wire itself did not become magnetized at all, essentially. But anytime you have current going through a wire, you produce a magnetic field, and that idea is called magnetic induction. I'm gonna overdo it, sorry, because next week we have to learn about electromagnetic induction, and they're not the same thing. Okay. We'll do it 27 times, so you get it, that's okay, that's fine.
So a magnetic field is different than an electromagnetic field?
A magnetic field is different than an electric field, yeah. As far as I know, there's no such thing as an electromagnetic field. There's an electric field, there's a magnetic field. Right now, we are talking about producing what?
Magnetic fields.
Magnetic fields, not electric fields. There's also one there, but we're talking about producing or magnetic fields. I'll get it. All right, that's pretty good. All right, so here's the. You want to take a break first? Or you want the new idea?
Break.
All right, take a break. Okay, 2 minutes. Take a break. Okay, fair enough. Yeah, this is a big idea.
Just hidden under all his paperwork.
Oh my god!
Kind of. Yeah, that's a pretty big bag.
Yeah.
How strong is it?
It's
pretty strong. Yeah, what is this here? Is it really just your air pressure release or something?
Really strong shard of a magnet.
Okay. I'm relatively sure that that's neodymium.
Yeah. That's
the
charge.
That makes no, it is kind of.
Okay. Do you? Are you looking at ones?
Yeah.
Yeah. All gone there.
Oh, exactly.
That's my.
I'm not really sure what we've done with this before, but you can see it's kind of burnt. You see that? I don't know. It was attached to something.
Watch me get over 10% of the points.
I've forgotten our tiger case.
You should.
I'd
be kind of scared.
No, that ain't gonna give you power.
God.
You just have to do a man camp.
That would stop me having
to face it differently.
That would stop me. That would stop me.
Yeah, I wouldn't use it.
Bands of choir for
I love that music.
That's your opinion. Well, not while I'm in charge.
Just listen to this at prom.
See, that's the point of giving me
the thing is, you can't really hear that, can you?
Exactly.
Oh, you can flip
the
switch.
Like the button,
yeah, you can hear the button. That's pretty good.
That's the point.
Because if I go just a little bit too far, it attaches itself. Yeah. It attaches itself. Now I'm not making much music.
Oh.
Well, guess think about it too. Old telephones, like the kind that are attached to the wall.
Oh, man.
Okay. This is half of that. Okay, when you put your you know, this kind of telephone, aren't there two ends? Obviously, you speak into one, and you listen in the other.
Yeah.
What's in here?
The speaker.
True. So what's in here? Coils of wire and a magnet. So inside the phone, this is the hearing part. We'll get to the speaker, the speaking part next week. Don't you put your ear over here? Right? And the speaker goes, blah, 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 blah. Somebody talks to you, back and forth. This is half of the phone. The other half, weirdly enough, is the same stuff. But we haven't explained how that works. So right now, I think we understand how this works. When I turn this on, coils a wire with current in them produce a magnetic field. So this magnetizable stuff becomes magnetized. Apparently, right now, it's an attraction. You can see it being pulled. It doesn't work very well. If I flip the leads around, what happens?
It
Should repel. And then you can't really get it back, it's a problem. Yeah. But I can't get it back, it's a problem. So I want it to be pulled and relaxed, not be shoved away and relaxed, because I can't get it pulled back. So, that's how any speaker works, in particular. So even in your cell phones, it's small now, isn't it? It's pretty small, but that's how the speakers in your cell phone work too, so you can hear.
So that's what happens if you wire up your speakers backwards?
Well, say that again?
So that's what happens if you, like, if a car speaker, if you wire it backwards, that's what happens.
What happens?
It pushes it instead of pulls it.
So it doesn't work? Have you ever tried it?
No, I've never.
Okay.
I'm just wondering.
See, I'm having a hard time. Because I think it'd be okay. Because in a car speaker, rather than the current going on and off, it goes one way and then the other way. So it pushes and then it pulls. I think it would be okay. I don't want to say that anybody ruin anything. I don't envision you something going out to
when you try
it anyway. You guys might, yeah. I don't think it would be a problem. Mine doesn't work because mine's on off.
Right.
But in a car, I think it would be current this way, then this way. So I think it would push pull. I think it would be okay.
I'm gonna try it.
I don't want to ruin anything. So don't say that my fog doesn't work.
We'll buy new speakers and put those in.
Okay. Here comes the next idea. It's a little tough, but we'll definitely get it. We'll slow down. If this is my proton one last time, I promise. What surrounds my proton right now? Field and a rotational field and nothing else. If it's an electron, same thing. If either one of them move, now they produce a magnetic field. Okay. So what if this moving thing were to come into a magnetic field that was already there? You mean what if something that was already magnetized because it's moving came into a magnetic field that was already there? What if something that was already magnetized came into a magnetic field that was already there? I wonder if there might be an interaction. So here's the next thought. If that's really bad. If this thing starts moving and creates its own magnetic field, and it enters a magnetic field that's already there, wouldn't the magnetic field that this thing creates interact with the magnetic field that it's entering? Yes, it would. In fact, the first time I saw this, I thought, wow, that is really cool. This one's going to work, I'm pretty sure. Pretty sure. I tried this one before you guys came in just to make sure. Sort of prop things up a little bit. Okay, so here's what I've done. I'm going to put a current carrying wire in a strong magnet. Muffin car, they needed to be here 3 minutes ago, didn't they? What have you got for us?
Muffin car is here, everyone.
I'm clairvoyant.
You know what?
Yeah, if you're going to do it, hurry up. That's fine.
Shard magnet is like so strong.
Oh, I hope it's all done. Did you been driving?
It really did work before you guys got here. It was perfect.
That's why my whole line doesn't leave my phone.
I just said that 1 o'clock last night, I was going to cut out power, so I went to my whole entire 24 pack of power.
Alright, let's try this. It'll work at least somewhat. I haven't turned the current on. When I turn the current on, it's going to go through this wire. The wire is going to produce a magnetic field of its own. But I put it in the middle of the strongest magnet that I have, which also has its own magnetic field. So the magnetic field is made by the wire, and the magnetic field of the nice big red horseshoe magnet probably interact. In fact, more than probably. Okay? Yeah, okay. Let's see what we get. I'm gonna turn it on. Let's see what we get. Yeah, all right. Seems to work better the other way, so let's try this one instead.
Oh.
Oh, maybe that's the movement.
Maybe it's the other one.
driving up front.
Good morning.
30% off.
Well, we don't need to close the
door. Discount buffers.
Oh, nice.
We don't need to close the door. No, I don't want to fight you. We don't need to close the door.
It's okay. You want to open.
Yeah, there we go. Thank you. Oh, you know what? And she's not here anyway. There you go. She's not here anyway.
But then, Peter, you can get out of school.
I'll take it.
At least it was a complete waste of time. That's good. That's pretty observable. I mean, I wish it would fly up to the ceiling. That'd be cool. But I would need more turn for something like that.
What's the main thing there?
Just like attach a car battery to it.
Oh, that was a pretty good one, wasn't it? No.
No.
What is it?
No.
Oh, magnetic induction.
Oh, we
don't
know the explanation. No, well. The
explanation.
The explanation is magnetic induction. The problem is we can't explain magnetic induction. So yes and no. Mm-hmm. Why did that work? And can you, by the time we get done, predict whether it goes up or down? Yes. Here's how this works. I'm going to say north is here, south is here. All magnetic fields point from north to south. They all point from north to south. Okay. So those are the magnetic field lines. Okay. We've already had one left-hand rule. Let's go through this real quickly. The first left-hand rule says, if current's flowing in a wire, you hold your thumb in the direction of the way that the electrons are moving, and the magnetic field lines wrap around in circles. That's left-hand rule number one. There's a second left-hand rule. Here's what it says. If, let's just say we throw electrons. Okay, Avery, get your electron to throw. Just throw it like that. Go ahead. So when it got here, which way is it going? So you have to hold your finger this way. Because you always hold your thumb the way the electrons are going. Even in the first left-hand rule, you do that. In the second left-hand rule, you still do that. So now you have to hold your hand this way, okay? Left-hand through, because you threw them that way, didn't you? Yeah. All right? This time, don't wrap your fingers. Hold them up like this. And give somebody a big high five, okay? Because the magnetic field is going from north to south. North to south. Knuckles, knuckles, north, north, knuckles, north, north. Don't they sound the same? They both start with N, don't they?
No.
No, but they sound like that. No, I know. North to south. Is it always north to south? Yes. So I had to hold my finger like this. There's a third piece you can't see that comes out of the palm of your hand. And that is the big... All right, without laughing too much, that's the big effing vector. That's the big force vector. Which says, if you throw electrons this way, in a magnetic field that points this way, they get shoved that way.
Oh.
So when Andrew throws it right at me, I'm going to sit here and go, ha, doesn't matter, because I'm going to go, shoo. They're not even going to hit me anyway.
Is that what the wire was doing?
Yes, essentially that was, the wire was going this way, the magnetic field was going this way, so the whole wire got shoved that way, and that's why it did that. Let's do that again. In the first left-hand rule, this is the way the electrons are moving, right? In the second left-hand rule, that's the way the electrons are moving. In the first left-hand rule, the magnetic field lines wrap in circles around your wire. In the second left-hand rule, don't wrap your fingers, but it's still the magnetic field lines from north to south. You have to hang on, you have to hold it that way. So again, if you threw an electron this way and it got pushed that way, wouldn't it gear off? So instead, how about I throw electrons at you? Oh! Now I have to hold my hand this way. But the magnetic field is flowing from north to south. So if I threw him at Aaron, and then my magnetic field goes like this, he'd be fine. Because they would go, because they get shoved that way, don't they? The force comes out of the palm of your hand. Can you recognize this? How many dimensions do we live in?
Three. Four.
Three. Well, okay. Spatially, three. And aren't they all perpendicular to each other?
Yeah.
We have an x-axis, we have a y-axis, we have a z-axis. We have an x-axis, we have a y-axis, and we have a z-axis. Those are the three directions, and they're all perpendicular to each other. Cool. could we instead throw, everybody throw the electron that way? Well, certainly we can do that. Let's try. You gotta hold your hand the correct way, though. Now you're throwing them this way in a magnetic field that points from north to south. So if you did throw them that way, they'd get forced this way, and they wouldn't travel that way when they go. Did I just do that right? Which way did I throw them? This way. Yeah. So you threw them this way, but they get shoved that way, so then they're off. What if you threw them that way? I have to hold my hand this way. And so now, which way are we throwing them? This way. So as they went that way, don't they get forced towards the board? So they don't keep going that way, they veer off this way. That's the second left-hand rule. All right, last question. What if you throw them up instead? Because so far we throw them at the board, we throw them away from the board, we throw them this way and throw them that way. Okay? And what if you throw them up? But what? But, I mean, so I gotta do this, and I gotta do this. There's no force whatsoever. The only force when they go like this. So weirdly enough, when you throw them along the magnetic field lines, nothing happens. They don't even know they're there. You throw them this way or this way, nothing happens whatsoever. You have to move them perpendicular to the magnetic field lines. Did you notice that I did that on purpose? This is a horseshoe magnet. This is north and this is south. So don't the magnetic field lines go this way? Which way did I put the wire compared to that? Perpendicular. You don't see anything. Should we prove that?
Oh, yeah.
Well, because isn't this, it's not going to be perfect. Isn't that more or less now along the magnetic field lines? Yeah, because it's not completely perpendicular over here. I need as close as I can. Nothing really happens. So, that's a lot of stuff to digest. Two left-hand rules. In both left-hand rules, this represents what? The electrons are moving, good. These are always magnetic field lines, but in the first left-hand rule, they wrap around and they show you which way the magnetic field lines go. In the second left-hand rule, they go this way, always north to south, and the force comes out of the palm of your hand. It's called the left hand. We're going to use it in a minute I'm going to try to get pretty big groups. This will still work. I don't know which end is north and which end is south. I want you to figure that out. Let me go grab, I have a couple more that don't look like that, but they're close. I wish I knew where we got these so I could get some more. These are just about as strong as those. In fact, be careful. These are pretty strong too. Okay. They don't say north and south on them. What I'm going to ask you to do, I'm going to move some stuff around a little bit. Get out. You're going to set up a circuit. And I don't care. You might as well use four batteries like we had before, okay? Like mine. And here's how you're going to do this. You know which way current goes in a circuit. It always flows from negative to positive, isn't it? Okay?
Yeah.
So you're going to put a wire through the middle of a magnet just like this. You are going to be the ones that's going to know whether the current's going this way or this way. You'll know that yourself. So you can hold your thumb the correct way. You guys are smart enough to look at a wire and know whether it goes up or down, aren't you? So isn't this if the wire goes up, don't you hold your palm up? If the wire gets forced down, don't you hold your palm down? And your fingers will automatically be pointing from north to south, and you can figure out which end is north and which end is south without my help. I'm down to 3 megs. I think Shoe borrowed a couple. So I have to have one for this front table, one for you guys, and one to have to crowd around a little bit. But you should be able to. Somebody wrote it on this one. I wouldn't believe them. Don't believe this. I don't know if it's true. The others aren't labeled at all. Okay? So what are you going to need? Set of batteries, for once in your life, don't put any resistors or light bulbs in it. Just have wires. We want lots and lots of current. Just some wires, right? How should you run it through the magnet? Like this?
Yeah.
Or like this?
Yeah.
Hey, you got to set it through perpendicular, otherwise you don't get any force, okay? You will know which way the current's going. You should hold your thumb the correct way. You're going to be able to tell whether the wire goes up or down. And as soon as you do that, oh, north to south. I just figured out which one it is, north and which one is south. Okay? All right, you guys take this one. So you're going to have to crowd around a little bit. You guys have to come over here a little bit. Go ahead and grab one of those white kits. Just for the battery packs. The batteries on the top should be in pretty decent shape, I would think. Yeah, move my stuff, Emily. Thank you. I got stuff going on. All right, what do you need? A battery pack? Wires? Yeah. And in fact, if you can do it with one, do it. I don't know if you can do it with one or not. And a magnet, a very strong magnet. I'll attempt to get some of this stuff out of the way. No more stuff on us.
Too much stuff.
Did you hide your plastic?
Yeah.
Did you?
I didn't do it very good.
You never know what that shit would think. I like him. He's kind of. You can do it with one wire. Look down. Oh, did it work? Did it? Well, don't hold it.
Just hold it.
Did it jump? Maybe it did. Maybe it did it by itself. So is it being forced up?
Oh.
Okay. But take a look at which way is the current flowing. Okay, that was definitely up. Okay, good. Which way is the current going?
Yeah.
Current goes from, okay, there we go. And you know, so automatically, which way is north, which way is south?
This one's
north. Okay, now something marked, is that green?
Yeah.
Okay. Try flipping the magnet around.
Hold it like harder.
Touch it.
Can you feel anything at all?
Yep.
Yeah.
Can you?
Yeah, it's going.
What's something?
It did move.
Did it?
Yeah.
Yeah, because I'm lifting it up and then I let it go.
Yeah.
Are you still touching it?
Yeah.
Do you feel anything? Wait, like this will go up.
What is it?
It went
yes.
Down.
Yes.
Oh!
That's
it.
It's okay. Yeah, we figured that out.
He's gonna bring your batteries for a second. So let's see if there's a
difference.
I doubt it.
The one that's actually
there's one.
It's capturing like the stars. This is
and you picked a nice thick wire.
I know about my.
Yeah, they also knew about witchcraft.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, but they.
Oh,
that was
not me.
Idea.
No, go ahead. That's
good. So if you were doing
that, that's pretty cool. Right?
Yeah,
okay.
Yeah,
so current goes this way. Found that way.
Well, yeah, but what electric?
Right. And you left any other side too. The wire got forced.
That would be a good
game to less position. It is
that
way. North to south, because it's been looking at using it before. That's pretty cool. Take their batteries back. I don't know if it's your batteries or the signals, but it wasn't.
They tried to push them so they would. They were like,
yeah, no, I don't know. You have anything to happen?
Yeah.
Okay. So, let me see real quick.
Warning.
Actually, no.
Maintain a minimum of
2 inches between the wires.
Okay, that's definitely down, isn't it? Okay. Current goes. Current goes north to south, or current goes negative to positive, right? Negative to positive. Wire got forced down. So north to south. Current goes from negative, so north to south. Okay, good. That's it. All right, put things down real quick. Good?
Yeah.
That's negative.
I thought this was.
so good.
This is a strong magnet. Are you sure this is just iron?
No, I'm not sure of anything.
What?
What?
We understand.
What? What is this?
They're just those.
Barely too short to bridge the two sides.
So shall we just leave it?
Alright, there's last piece. As soon as you say the word force in physics, all physics go, okay, cool, got it. What direction? We just took care of that. Now, we took care of that, right? Force comes out upon the end. Secondly, how much force?
A lot, yes.
The magnetic force so here's the formula coming, right? Here's the formula.
Oh, no.
How much force?
I'm not prepared. Many force.
Many force, many force.
Yes, force.
Mutual force.
Seven force.
Not always that.
Right. At least.
Again, let's refine the question. Force on what? The force on a charged thing that's moving through a magnetic field.
Yes.
That's the question. How much when a charged thing enters a magnetic field and gets forced, how much force is there? Well, probably depends on things like, weirdly enough, it doesn't. That you're on the right track. That will affect how it acts, but it won't affect, weirdly enough, for once in our lives, isn't that weird? There's something similar to that, though, but let's refine the question. If I, as a charged particle, enter a magnetic field, I feel this force on me. Okay, how much force depends on things like?
Velocity.
Yes. There's three things. Traditionally, you see that in the middle. It doesn't make any difference where it is, but traditionally, you'll see it in the middle. Yeah, how fast? Why? Well, because the faster it moves, the stronger magnetic field it makes. And so it gets affected more by the field that it just entered. Good, what else? Later, please. What about the field that just entered?
Yeah,
the strength of the field. That's exactly right. The strength of the magnetic field that it just came into. How do you abbreviate strength of the magnetic field that it just entered?
Just like that.
Yeah, it's like that. I love physics, and sometimes I hate this because strength of the magnetic field. No, it doesn't. But on your formula page, can't you just put a little magnetic field strength? That's what it stands for. I know it's a stupid line, right? Yeah, it has. So, but at least you're thinking really well. Yeah, fast, okay, that's got to matter. How strong the magnetic field is comes in, it matters. And actually thinking along the lines of math, because you're on the right track. It's how much charge, because if I have one thing that enters versus two, don't two things get pulled on gravitationally more than one thing? Two things get pulled around more electrically as well. Okay. How much charge? Do we have a letter for how much charge? Yes, we give us, yeah, it's another stupid letter. Yeah, QVB, yeah. Again, the order doesn't matter. Hey, for once in our lives too, nothing's squared. Don't have to worry about that stuff. So, and I'm assuming you understand we're going to multiply those three together.
Q is the charge of
the
object moving.
This is the charge of the thing that is doing the moving. Yes, well said. Measured in coulombs. Well, it's got to be in coulombs. So velocity is just measured in meters per second. That's not bad. Could be miles per hour, but we'd have different units over there. That's going to be meters per second. Again, this stands for magnetic field strength, but you got to have some units. And don't we always honor people in physics?
Yeah.
We always do. So it's measured in Teslas. Physics is so weird. This is named after a person, right? That's named after a person.
That makes sense.
Well, what's force measured in? Newton, that's named after a person, right? They're all so somehow, what's a coulomb times a meters per second times a Tesla? It's a Newton, of course.
Everything equal Newton.
Well, yeah, right, any force is always measured in newtons. So actually, they'll make these units come up to measure.
Newtons per second makes sense, though.
So.
Yeah, that's the only one that makes sense.
Got one.
Yeah, one makes sense.
A lot of dumb.
Okay, so, let's try one quick example, and I think you'll get it, because everybody here can multiply three numbers together, okay? There's about 15 of you. Let's say 15 electrons moving at a sprinter speed of 15 meters per second. I don't want to use the same number twice. 16 meters per second. Happen to enter a field that has a strength of 0.7 teslas. Here's a problem. So can you all multiply three numbers together?
No.
Yes. But are you going to put 16 in here?
Sure.
Are you going to put 0.7 in there?
Yes. Yeah.
Are you going to put 15 in there?
No.
You got to change it in coulombs. 15 out of.
Was it 6.6?
6.24.
2 bar, 2 bar. Okay. So you're getting a really small number.
Are we?
You're going to get probably something times 10 to the negative 17th, maybe?
How do you do that?
Okay, Emily, legitimate question. I already know that if you take 1 divided by 6.24 times 10 to the 18th, you get 10 to the negative 19th. Factor of 10, factor of 10. So I just wasn't asking. I know.
I'll take
it.
Not practice.
Yes, that's all it is. It's like asking, why do you guys know French so well? Whatever, just because you
don't.
Sure.
Or whatever you just said.
I am going to know French.
Yeah, so is it 2.69? Okay.
I used to take one trimester of French.
Yes, I
did. Beer.
Hey. That would make sense. All
right, here's my question, and you guys are the ones that can tell me. Is physics A or B harder? But is it harder because it's harder, or it's harder because that's the first one you take and you're not used to thinking at this level?
I think it's hard,
particularly because there's so many, I don't know why it's true, and it's supposed to bother you. I think half of the reason people think physics B is easier is because you finally get used to working this level and you stop groaning about it. You said I was going to do it. Okay. It's human nature, I get it, it's fair. That's a lot of stuff, but there's nothing left to learn from this week. Okay. It's gonna redo it in different scenarios. We're done learning stuff for this week. And that, you know what? And then when that wire flipped up, I'm like, that is way cool. That is cool. Yes.
I have a.